Hello, welcome to a new episode. Today's topic is the logistic regression part 1. We'll be talking about how to fit the coefficients of the logistic regression. Some of the basic properties of the logistic regression are there's one dependent variable which is also called the response. Its possible values are 1 or 0. There can be one or more independent variables. Unlike the dependent variable, there's little restriction on the possible values of the independent variables. It is a supervised learning method, and it can be used to forecast the probabilities of the response variable. Let's suppose that we have k independent variables. They are usually denoted as x1, x2, up to xk. Let's suppose that we have one dependent variable, also called the response. It is usually denoted as y. Y can be either 1 or 0. This is equivalent to saying that y can be either true or false, one class or another, and so on. Now suppose that there is a variable s which couples linearly to the independent variables. By linear coupling, we mean this functional form. Then there is a so-called logistic function which connects the variable s with the response y. The logistic function gives the probability of the response y having value equal to 1. Its functional form is as shown here. We can also plot the logistic function as shown here. When s is positive, it approaches 1. And when s is negative, it approaches 0. Okay, now it's time to go through an example on the Excel spreadsheet. We have the Excel file named Example Logistic Regression Fit. We can see that there are three independent variables represented by the columns x1, x2, and x3. The dependent variable or the response is given by the y column. We can see that the y column contains only ones and zeros, as it should. By the way, where does this table come from? Well, this is a simulated data of student admission records. The variables have the following meanings. X1 is the score of the test 1. X2 is the score of the test 2. X3 is the number grade. Y is the admission result. If the student was admitted, we have value 1. If the student was rejected, we have value 0. Now, let's fit the coefficients using PrimaXL. We go to the PrimaXL tab. Click on it to bring up its ribbon menu, and then click on the arrow under the button named Logistic, and then select Fit. A menu form appears. This menu form is quite intuitive. We can fit it out starting from the top. At the topmost field, we should specify the data range of the independent variables. Next, we should specify the data range of the dependent variable y. Finally, at the bottom, we should specify where to output the result. Okay, let's just do it. We can click on the small button to bring up the range input form where it can easily select the data range and return. For here again, click select and return. Click, select, and return. Okay, I think we are ready. Now, just press the run button. Great, we have the result. Let's format the numbers so that they look nicer and then interpret what they mean. Let's just focus on the result as shown here. In the first column, we have the labels. Intercept means the coefficient beta 0, coef 1 means beta 1, coef 2 means beta 2, and so on. In the second column, we have the coefficient values. Then in the third column, we have the corresponding errors. In the next column, we have the Z statistics, which are calculated by dividing the coefficient value by the error. In the last column, we have the p-values. The p-value is such that the smaller it is, the more statistically significant the coefficient is. Usually, when the p-value is smaller than 0.05, we say that the corresponding coefficient is statistically significant. Here we can say that all the coefficients are significant except for the second one, or beta 2. The associated variable is x2. Thus, we may interpret that the score of the test 2 does not help in understanding the admission decision. Finally, a summary. Today, we covered the topic of the logistic regression. We talked about how to fit the regression coefficients. We also talked about the standard errors. Then we discussed about the p-values and the statistical significance of the coefficients. There are some related topics that we'd like to cover in the future episodes. For example, how to forecast using the logistic regression, how to train and then test using the logistic regression, how to extend the simple logistic regression we covered today when the y variable can have values other than ones and zeros. Then the topic of linear regression is also in our agenda. Excellent! I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Thank you so much. Until next time, bye.